Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is an overview of all my Jason Voorhees figures from NECA, and this is the Ultimate 9. This video is inspired by the review spot. About a year ago, he did his video of his overview of the figures, and well, since then, we got a lot of new Jason figures, and in this video, I'm going to show you them all. We have 11 figures to go over, so I don't want to spend too much time on each of them. We have reviewed most of them. I will spend a little bit more time on the ones we haven't reviewed. I thought I would review this video. I did just complete my NECA Ultimate collection yesterday, so yay for that. But the first character I want to talk about is Pamela Voorhees. This is the only Pamela Voorhees action figure we have. We have the sideshow figure and the cloth, retro cloth figures, but in plastic form, this is the only one we have. And my biggest wish for NECA to do is an Ultimate Pamela Voorhees figure, and she could come with a machete, a million different weapons, and better articulation, and that would be a lot better. I think a lot of people would want her. But until then, we have this. I'm not going to review her in this video because I do have a separate review on my channel if you want to check her out. But Pamela Voorhees is my favorite horror killer. Jason is actually number 3. My number 2 spot would be Michael Myers. But hey, we're talking about Jason in this video, but I just wanted to give a mention to Pamela Voorhees. But that won't be the only mention Pamela will get in this video. So, of course, we're going to start out with probably the most unique out of all of them, because all the other Jasons have the hockey mask on, and that is Part 2 Jason. And here's the box for Part 2. Very unique box art. I think this box art was for, sorry if you can hear the dog walking. I think this box art was for the, this box itself. You get nice back pictures. There's Pamela's head right there. Really wish, this came with the shrine, like the 25th anniversary box set did. And you open it up and you have all the weapons in there. Some are taken out, but most of them are put in there. But there's another image of Jason. Don't want to spend too much time on the box. But, oops, I gotta stand up for me. But here's the figure. And the figure is pretty nice. He is super articulated, or for a NECA figure anyways. We'll go ahead and take out his pickaxe, which is very nicely done, has some blood on it. I tried to display my Jasons with something different besides the machete. Some of them have the machetes, but I like to display my Jasons with something different. But you get the sack head right there. Just the detail on him is very nice. I'm pretty sure I reviewed him, so I don't want to spend too much time on him. There's the back from him. And, just to give him his pickaxe. Just doing this off camera, it's easier. And then he also came with the head of Pamela Voorhees, which I don't know if this is the same head as the one in the 25th anniversary box set, but nice to get something. I count it as in my Pamela Voorhees collection. Nice to get something of her in, you know, ultimate form. Even if it's not a full figure, it's her head. And then we get one of the coolest accessories that there is, and that is the campfire. And very cool, very, the fire can come off, you just want the wood. But the fire effect is very cool, and then the rocks around it is very cool as well. So I'm going to try to get this box to stand up, because I really want it to stand up. Don't know why it's not standing up, because yeah, there we are, kind of. Next, we're gonna just move Jason over there, and we're gonna move on to the next Jason. Next, we have Friday the 13th, Part 3. Now, I technically already had this figure because it was released. I forgot to get it down, but it was released years ago on a single card. There was a clean version, and there was a battle damage version. Here's the box really fast. Just going to show it really fast. It's Friday the 13th, Part 3, and Part 3 was in 3D, so the box is 3D. A little damaged, but that's okay. This is the side. There's the back. This is the other side. Top. And it opens. And there's the inside right there. So, gonna stand up again. This box was kind of damaged when I got it. I just got this one in last week, I think. Alright, sorry about that. I just wanted to get the box to stand up. Anyways, here is Part 3 Jason. As I was saying, this was a mix. There was a damaged version and a clean version before this. This is a mix of the clean, both, so it's both damaged and clean. So I just got it pretty much for this video. I wasn't gonna get it, but I said to myself and to others that, hey, if I'm gonna do a video, I have to get them all. I put the pitchfork in his hand, just to give him something different besides the machete. But there's the pitchfork. Pretty simple, but he did come with another head. I didn't get all the accessories out because I didn't want to spend the video talking about all the accessories and stuff, but the detail on him is pretty nicely done. Nicely done. You can see it all on his clothes and stuff. You can see the blood right there. You can see his hunchback, and just again, the folds and wrinkles are very nicely done. And if we take off his mask, which you can't do with the Part 2 one because, it is, a sack mask. It comes with an alternate head though. But here's his mask. I feel like the other version was a little better, looked a little bit more like Part 3, but, this one looks more like Part 4, but here's the face. You do get an alternate head sculpt that has the axe wound in it, and you can put the axe in it. That's why there's blood right there. But there's Part 3. If we put the mask back on, the mask sits nicely on his head. You can see the eyes a little bit in there, not too much, but you can. And if we just give him his pitchfork back, gotta have something to kill with. Getting revenge for Mom. If Mom never died, Jason wouldn't come back. At least I don't think. And if we just move... I hate boxes that cannot stand. But now we'll just put Jason right there. And oops, sorry, and we'll move the fire and the head right there. Now, before we take a look at Part 4, we're actually going to cut to the NES Jasons. These are my newest Jasons. I got this one for my birthday last month. Here's the box for that one. It is a San Diego Comic-Con exclusive in 2013. Here's the box side. I didn't review this one, obviously. Here's the back. If you want to pause and read that, you can. What he comes with. If we open it up. You and your friends are dead. Game over. And there's where the figure would be. And I think the machete is still in there, yeah. Because I gave him the axe. But this one is pretty cool. He is based off his game experience, game appearance. And I, like I said, I gave him the axe. They're both glow in the dark. Oops. And here's the axe. It's translucent. It's glow in the dark. And there's a handle right there if you want to see focus. And right there too. But this one is translucent also. It also shares the same body as part 3. If we take the mask off, we'll just go ahead and do that. The mask is also translucent, as you can see my fingers through it. It's okay, but you can see the face sculpt is the exact same sculpt as part 3 Jason. And the body is the same sculpt as well. So we won't go too much into the body or the face sculpt, because if we just put his axe back in. Oopsie. Do this off camera. Don't want to break any figures here. Because the next figure is another NES Jason, and I just got this figure yesterday, and he's a little different. He's the same sculpt. Here's his box. Now, this box was supposed to play music, but for some reason mine doesn't. It's the exact same box, pretty much, except for little different details. I think the read-up's the exact same, but you can pause and read if you want to read that. But won't spend too much time on that box either. The figure is the exact same, except for a few minor details. And instead, this figure comes with the floating head of Pamela Voorhees. It's a pretty big head. Here's a comparison of the two heads. Right there. You can see she's a boss in the game, and you can, if you want, take her off, but all she's gonna do is she's just gonna sit by Jason if you don't have her on the stand. I think the stand was a good addition to the figure, and it's a little top heavy, but put her aside right there. But the figures are the exact same, but this time, instead of being translucent, the figure is all matte color. It's just a solid blue color. I gave him the machete this time. Won't take that out of his hand. For some reason, on mine, my hand is very loose and it comes out, so I don't want to break it. And the faces are exactly the same as well, except there is some black lining on the faces. Just bring them in, and you can see this. The second Jason has red orange eyes, which give him a very creepy look. So yeah, and but it shares the same mold as the Part 3 Jason, and the first NES Jason as well. So so very cool. I wanted both. For some reason, my mask doesn't sit all the way on his head. Strap doesn't sit on all the way on his head, so it is up a little. But if it was the same figure, I wouldn't have got it, but I did want the Pamela head because, of course, I had it in my Pamela collection as well. Stay tuned, I'm going to take an updated picture of my Pamela collection probably after this video. Now we get to, we'll just put Pamela right there. We get to part 4. Here, oh God, not going to stand again. But we'll get to part four. And this was one of the first Ultimate figures I got. Very similar to part three. For some reason, mine is very loose in the legs. But here's the box. Won't spend too much time on the box. I'm pretty sure I did review this figure. But there's the inside, the side, the back, and stuff like that. And okay, sorry about that. I had to get the box standing. I just leaned it against the other boxes. But this is part four, Jason. I'm not going to spend too much time on this because Review Spot has reviewed this figure many times. And in his overview of his Jason Ultimate figures, he talks about this one too. I just really want to get to the new ones. But I gave him the machete as well. You know, the machete is Jason's trademark weapon, so you're going to be displaying him with the machete. But very similar to part three, he has a shirt on and pants on. Very dirty, detailed fingernails. I like the bent finger right there. If we take off his mask, there's his mask right there. It has the axe wound in it and everything. And the face sculpt is a little different. Like the part three Jason, this did come out previous on a single card. It had a battle damage version 2, and I did not get those, so this was my first part 4 Jason. I do have the Mezco one though, but the face sculpt is amazing. I think it looks just like him, and a very gruesome face sculpt, but obviously you're going to keep the mask on. He came with a bunch of accessories. I have elsewhere, they're not in the box because I took them out, but one of them is probably my favorite accessory, and that is the tombstone of Pamela Voorhees. Pamela Voorhees, 1930 to 1979, at rest. Again, I count it in my Pamela collection, so very cool to have that in my collection. Now we're going to get to the new ones that, well, one of the new ones, one of the ones Review Spot has already. I'm going in movie order, so, oopsie, please stand. And that is Friday the 13th, Part 5, A New Beginning. And that is the dream sequence, Jason. And I'll bring him in. And he pretty much is a copy of part 4 Jason, just a couple of things different. If he stands, I have the axe in his hand and everything, but here is his box. Just go over it really fast. This is dream sequence. You got Tommy Jarvis right there, hockey mask right there, part 5 New Beginning Jason. It comes with multiple different masks you can choose from. I left the machete in there this time because I gave him the axe. And then there is a read-up you can pause and read if you want. And pictures of the figure. So, very cool. Now, this is not standing up either. Come on, stand up. Thank you. But here's the dream sequence, Jason. One thing I don't like about this figure is you cannot take any of his masks off. They are all molded onto his face. But the one reason I put this Jason like this, because in part 5, Tommy keeps seeing visions of Jason. And he has the axe like this in his hand, so, and the blood coming down on his mask. And but the body is pretty much a reuse of the part 4 body. But it is pretty cool still. Like I said, I give him the axe to just have something different on your shelf, you know. Just to look different. And he was like this in the movie, even though he wasn't the main killer in the movie. But still pretty cool. Again, had to get it to add to the collection. One of the things he comes with is a tombstone or a wooden stone, wooden grave mark as well. And this is pretty cool because you get the dirt and stuff like that. And it says Jason Voorhees. I think the Pamela one is cooler, but that's just because she's my favorite. So, but you get this one too. So, pretty cool figure. Not my favorite though. So next one is actually not Jason. Oh, you're gonna stand. Thank God this one stands. It is actually Roy Burns. And I remember in Review Spot's video, he wanted a Roy Burns figure. And finally, we have one. We just have a few more figures to go, guys. We finally have one. Here's the box. I'm just gonna set him over there for now. Friday 13th, New Beginning, hockey mask. We get that mask with the Dream Secrets, Jason. The side, the back, and a read up if you want to pause and read. And then if we open it up, you get a bunch of accessories with this figure, and I haven't taken them out. I just left them in the box because I only use one accessory for him, but you do get the option. And let's get talking about the figure now. Thank God this box stands on its own. I gave the figure the garden shears or the clippers or whatever you want to call them. But the figure is different than other Jason figures because he's in a boiler or a jumpsuit, mechanics outfit, whatever you want to call it. And I'm not going over articulation on these guys because the articulation is pretty much the same on all of these. But the figure is great. The garden shears are pretty cool. They can move. They're in both hands, so it's a little harder to move. The mask is pretty cool, and it's blue on the other side. Not sure why it's blue like that, but the mask is pretty cool. There's the face, pretty cool that you see the face, because in the movie we don't really see this, and we don't see under the mask until the very end when he's dead. Spoiler alert. Just very cool. You get a gash right there. And the details and stuff on him is pretty cool as well. Just gonna put the mask back on because it looks a little funny without it on. But the ball cap is pretty cool as well. It's funny, but it's pretty cool as well. Alright, we just have three more figures to go over. And then that will be the end of the video. What I'm gonna do is, pause and just save time to, and I'll be back. Next, we have Part 6 Jason, and Review Spot already reviewed this figure in his overview, so I won't go in too much detail about it, but here's the box, really fast. There's the cover, open it. Most of the accessories are out because I use them. There's a read-up you can pause and read. Pictures of the figure and what he comes with and everything else. I only have 10 minutes left, so I'm not going to go over the box too much. But here's the figure, and he's pretty cool. This one is a little different. He has a garden belt on and garden gloves on. A little bit funny. He does come with a machete and knife. I actually had the fence post in his hand, but it broke, so I can't display him the way I wanted to when I first got this figure, and I really don't want to get another figure of this one because I see no point in having two figures of this Jason. Just there's no point in my opinion because he doesn't come with alternate heads, but if we take the mask off, you get the gruesome face right there. You don't really see too much in the movie because it's all rainy and mud's all over it, but you get a face right there. By this point, he's a zombie. You get covered eyes on the mask, as you can see, so you can't see his eyes. Pretty good figure. I like it. You get a machete, which can go in his holster as well as in his knife. They're already in there. I'm not going to take them out. Or maybe I'll just take them out really fast. But it's just a clean machete. Nothing too special. But there is part 6 Jason, and you get some blood on his pants. And the details on him is pretty nice as well. Two more, guys. Two more. Next, we have... before I get started on the next figure, this tombstone comes with the Part 6 Jason. It's just a tombstone and says Jason Voorhees on it. It's nicely sculpted, though. So put that right in front of him. The next figure is the Freddy vs. Jason figure. And that is Jason from Freddy vs. Jason. Here's the box. There's the side. There is the back. Pause and read if you want to. Image of the figure. And what the figure comes with. Again, I leave all my accessories in the box if I'm not using them. So all the accessories are in the box except the ones I'm using. And then you get an image right there. So there is Freddy vs. Jason box. Now, this is probably one of the coolest Jason figures ever, actually. Well, probably one of my favorites. Not necessarily my favorite Jason look, but it is my favorite Jason. You get a machete. Whoopsie. Sorry, Rory. As I was saying, you get a machete with a really cool flame effect on it. You can put it on either way, and you get a bloody machete. You also do get a clean machete, but it's still in the box. But there's those. I decided to use the bloody machete because in that one scene with the flame on his machete, he is killing people. And this figure is pretty cool. That he's in this really kind of raggedy outfit, and he has a jacket on, and I think he has gloves on because his hands are all black. If we take off his mask, he comes with a couple of different masks, but I decided to go with the one with the claw marks on it. But there it is. Not a big fan of the face sculpt. The face sculpt's just okay, but in the movie we only saw up to his mouth like that. We never saw his eyes or nose or anything, so I think they just guessed unless they had behind the scene pictures of or something. But you get some hair on the back, and so pretty cool figure. He is taller than all of the other Jason figures, and he, because of his disco boots, what I call them, or Frankenstein boots, he's Disco Jason. There is Freddy versus Jason. Next Jason is the last Jason. Last but not least is the remake Jason. And that, here's the box for him. You can open it up. Accessories are still inside, or most of them. Here's the flab. And there's the side. And there's the back. Again, pause and read if you want. And there's the images right there. And just gonna slide that in there. But here's the figure. And the figure is pretty cool. He has nicely done details on him. You can see the sculpt is really nice. I gave him the machete because it's just like a sword. It's just huge. He does have a sheath if you want to put it in there, though. If we take off his mask, very gruesome face sculpt. You don't really see it in the movie. You kind of see it in the shadows. He has long hair, which I know most people aren't a fan of the long hair. But the detail on his jacket is pretty nicely done, as well as his pants and shoes. And the hockey mask is cool as well. So yeah, there is the remake Jason. Pretty cool figure. So here is a quick overview of all the Jason figures that we talked about in today's video. I have to go fast because my camera is running out of memory. And let me know which ones are your favorite. Sorry, which one is your favorite? I have to say... Oops, that was the tripod. I have to say my favorite is... I really like part 6, but I'm probably going to go with the part 4, Jason. Come on, stand up, remake, Jason. Yeah, so let me know what your thoughts are down below. Please subscribe to my channel. As always, all my information is down below. Check out my Instagram. That's the page I'm most active on. And as always, have a great day. And let me know which Jason is your favorite. And please subscribe to my channel. And until the next video, I will see you guys later. Bye.